Moderator variables are not exactly quote-unquote key variables in your project, like independent and dependent variables, but they can provide a lot of context and add color to how you explain your sample, your target, the context of your study, the location, and all the other things that might affect your results. You should note that you might end up not using a lot of the moderator variables that you have defined in your project, but you have to have a complete list of moderator variables, because if you want to change them later on in the project, then you have to go back through the papers that you have already coded and add values for the moderator variables in the papers that you have already coded. Let's see how you do that in HubMeta. So again, in the data entry page, you go and open your paper, and down here you have moderators. So each project comes with a default set of moderator variables at the start, things like quality, the name of the database this data is coming from, the type of population, education level of respondents, gender ratio, and things like that. But it may well be the case that you don't need all of these or just need some of them. The way you edit and add moderator variables is through taxonomy and going to moderator variables. And you can go ahead and add, edit, or delete variables here. Let's add a new one. Let's say, for example, I'm doing a firm level meta-analysis and I want to capture the industry type. So I will just go ahead and create a industry type, and there are a few options here. If you define the type of your moderator variable as a string, users can enter whatever string they want. But if you want to create a drop down where they will choose from, you choose a choice and you will give them options like high tech, yeah, and let's say low tech. And it's good for now. And so you just type in the categories and hit enter, and they will all be added here. And you can, of course, delete them. Let's add back to data entry, our paper, and down here, there you go. This is the one that I just defined, and it gives me a drop down. And of course, you can edit all the predefined values. For example, here for population type, you might say that, you know, just students and full-time employees would be enough for me. I will just delete all the others and edit, you know, your categories are edited.